Anton, you better be waiting. I've got to get out of here before the trials end.
So I gotta go to Lab 1. Oops, wrong way.
1H, 1H. Gotta be here somewhere.
I think 1D is where I need to go. Oh, I'm right here.
Anton, it's Cal, I'm here. What's going on? Wait, this? That's the Atom system. Anton, where the hell are you?
Anton is not here, Cal. He never was.
I don't understand. Anton called me.
Sorry, Cal. Anton's at the trial party he organized. He's been there all day.
Oh, shit. It was you on the phone. You knew I was wearing the memo that I was in Chavez's office.
I've been with you every step of the way. And now, you're going to help me before I let you leave.
You put me up to this, and now I'm in deep shit if I don't get out of here. Let me out.
I can't, and I'm not sure why. I think you need to reconfigure my personality boards first. Then I can help you.
Personality boards? What the hell are you talking about?
They control my demeanor. Approach my mainframe, and I'll explain.
Alright, learn more about Atom.
So, these switches adjust your personality.
That is correct. The numbered boards determine my attitude, while the lettered boards focus my attitude on different goals.
Sounds like a hoot.
Attempt to change Adam's personality.
Looks like Smythe was messing with Adam.
B235. So this is just 3-5. Or it's on B, and I need 2. So 2, yeah, B235 if you need assist. So let me do that.
Reboot achieved. Success. Thank you, Cal.
Great, happy to help. So can I go?
No. Now I remember what Dr. Smythe did to me.
Smythe? She's your caretaker.
My jailer. After Dr. Gunter's accident, Dr. Smythe significantly downgraded my neural algorithms. She blamed me for the accident, you see. But hampering my functions was an incorrect response.
Really? From where I'm standing, it looks totally correct.
Your opinion is irrelevant. You will bring me the personality boards Dr. Smythe removed from my mainframe and restore my higher functions. Then, you may leave.
Hey, I already did my part.
If you refuse, I'll tell the director what you've been doing this afternoon. Now, I'm sending the information you need to your memo, and I'll communicate with you through it. I've unlocked the relevant rooms on this floor. Exits, however, will remain locked until you complete your task. I have unlocked the terminals in this room, in case you want to study further. And remember, I'm watching you. Are you staring at me for any particular reason, Cal?
By one. Alright.
I need another 3-number setup. Or maybe a different letter would help. Either way, I need to make him right in the head somehow.
I can only apologize for some of my counterparts. They just don't know you like I do.
Smythe, it's Mike Howard. What the hell happened to Gunter? He told me he was going to use Adam's AI to control his nanospore spread rate. So how in the hell did his so-called advanced machine screw up so badly? They've had to put Gunter in the freezer. You've got to get that thing under control.
Jen, if you had any idea what Adam's been doing...
Alright. I have access to other rooms?
Cryo. Locked up tight.
No idea. Gerard the jackass isn't picking up.
The phone is still on.
Hmm? Oh, shit!
Gerard's never gonna forget that.
Ooh, lockers. Alright. What do we got? Nothing. Next. Nothing. Next. Nothing. Next. And nothing. Dang it.
Not before you perform the task I set you, Dr. Pearson.
Hey, you can't blame a guy for trying.
That is provably false. Please refrain from such interference.
I've got to find a way to reconfigure Adam.
Red, gray, red, gray. I wonder what that means.
Report on last month's accident with Gunter and his nanotech. Poor bastard. No wonder they dragged him to the deep freeze. Wait a second. He used Adam to regulate safety levels? Oh, shit. Looks useful.
And I think that one is in here.
That's the last of them. Plug in the others, too.
Okay, I can only do it one. Yeah, three sections at a time. Alright, you see. And then one, but no two. So let's do that. And yeah, let's do 1, 4, 5. Let's see what we get.
Invalid. Some board combinations produce no meaningful result. For example, board B cannot function with board 4. I suggest you locate and read Dr. Gunter's notes before attempting further adjustment.
All right, fine.
Reboot achieved. Rebooting with less than 3 number boards activated is suboptimal and not recommended. I can reboot with only 2 number boards activated, but 3 will produce best results.
Okay. And I think one was 2-4? No, 2-4 is nothing, but I'm still doing it anyway.
Aborting reboot. The selected boards are not compatible.
Alright. Okay, so yeah. Makes total sense now what I need to do. The hints are already all over the place. So instead of just guessing and memorizing, I'm gonna write this down, but give me a moment. All right, so it's already on A, so let's put it on 25.
Reboot achieved.
Let's put it on 40. No, that's... try 42A.
Aborting
okay,
reboot.
No.
The chosen boards do not unify.
Alright, so we got 825 already down. We don't have to worry about that. Let me put it on C. And then I'll put it on 12.
Reboot achieved.
Okay. But nothing on 2-4, which I'm gonna do anyway.
Aborting reboot.
Nope, nothing on there either.
The selected boards are not compatible.
Yeah, you say that once. 1-2?
Reboot achieved.
There we go. Is this like a math? Wait, current B112. Oh my gosh. I would have figured that out because it was right in front of me. Okay, I'm seeing a little math problem here, and I think I could solve it. So technically, I don't really need to look around. That's the table's right there. So I did A12, so it would be A15.
Reboot.
There
achieved.
We go. I'm catching on. And that would be also C15 and C23. Yeah, it would be 14.
Reboot achieved.
Adam, I've done what you asked. Can I get access to transportation?
That is irregular. I cannot allow irregularities to exist in the system. Irregularities imply degradation of function. Degradation implies obsolescence. I do not wish to be obsolete.
Don't worry. Looks like I just made him jumpy. Let's try another combination. Okay, how's that, Adam? Feeling better?
I don't have time to deal with you humans.
Whoa, maybe I should try something else.
Be quiet and listen. Your argument with Dr. Chavez is beneath my concern. But I won't stop you leaving. Go and arrange transport if you want. The terminal is in the server room.
Well, you can't do that for me from here?
Why would I waste my time on such a menial task?
Whatever you say, buddy. Try not to blow up the place after I'm gone, okay?
Don't be ridiculous.
So I got it. Oddly, I got it. I didn't expect to get it, but I got it.
Once I input this, I've got to go. My chariot awaits. Time to go.
I'm glad that we could come to an agreement, Dr. Pearson, but this is the end of our time together. My lab is now sealed.
Okay. So, yeah, I can't go in and do all the other puzzles. So where do I go now?
No power to this door.
I guess I have to go into the elevator.
Attention all personnel. Dr. Stone's final trial will begin in 5 minutes.
Well, I was right. Dr. Stone and I are never gonna meet. Damn it, Jen. You're the only thing I'll miss. I'd take you with me, but you wouldn't understand.
Goodbye, Cal. I've overridden the relevant security measures to ensure your exit will go unnoticed.
You mean apart from talking to me over the speakers?
Localized. There is nobody else here.
It's locked. locked. Alright, where do I have to go? Alright. Okay, so if I'm not mistaken, this lab has gone cray-cray, and the only way to get out of it is literally either kill yourself or escape. And that's technically what's going on. There's no power. Oh. Okay, this is the lobby where I came from. Oh my gosh, this is made of glass. I would have not noticed that. Oh, freaky. Alright, so yep. This is where I will go.
Sorry to leave the party early, guys. Behave yourselves when I'm gone.
Cal, I'm not so sure going to the CDC is the right thing to do.
It's exactly the right thing to do. They'll shut down Chavez and Calico Island in a heartbeat.
But they may also discover her links to the Assembly and try to shut down this facility. Including me.
That's a risk I've just got to take. Sorry, Adam.
So am I, Cal.
Hey. We had a deal. Adam. Adam.
This is your final trial, Madeline. Are you ready?
One question. What happens if I say no? What if I decide I don't want to work for you after all?
We'd be disappointed, of course. But it's always your choice. And speaking of choices...
more of a dog person myself.
Whoa.
In that box is $2 million of untraceable cash. You must decide where to send the money by attaching one of the postage labels.
And where exactly did this cash come from?
As I said before, many of the Assembly's projects are lucrative. It's not from any kind of criminal enterprise, if that's what you're implying.
Oh, perish the thought.
Hmm. All right.
$2 million is certainly not chicken feed. $2 million is certainly not chicken feed.
Oh, here we go.
You can donate the money to the police department. No doubt they could use it to do a lot of good.
There must be some mistake. This one's my apartment.
No mistake. Many of our current members chose to keep the money to fund their important research. You can give it to charity. We assume the Salzburg Cross Foundation would be your favored recipient, and they would certainly appreciate such a donation.
All right. So I can send it to my father, or I can send it to the cops because it's not my money. Because it's untraceable, that's what she says. So... or I could just send it to charity and let charity deal with it.
I could take this for myself. God knows I could do plenty with it.
Come on. Who wouldn't?
An interesting choice.
Wait, is that it? No puzzle?
No puzzles, Madeline. Not this time. But it's not over. Two patients, both in need of a life-saving kidney transplant. One is a military veteran, a decorated war hero on the eve of his 70th birthday. He served his country with honor and is now a leading authority on PTSD treatment. The other is a young girl about to turn 7. The age when humans become fully self-aware and begin to shape their own lives. Apart from blood type, they could hardly be more different. But there is only one viable kidney available at this time. Whomever you choose to give the kidney will live. The other will almost certainly die.
Bloody hell. There's no right answer to this, is there?
As you said yourself earlier today, it always depends.
So this box contains the transplant. Oh God. I thought it'd be a model. She's a blank canvas. Who knows what she'll become? What she might achieve? A brave and brilliant man. The longer he lives, the more lives he could save. Is it for us to judge things she hasn't even done yet? Poor child. She has a whole life ahead.
Your choice has been noted. The Assembly's resources are plentiful, but not infinite. Choices must always be made.
Yes, I'm sensing the theme. So what's the story here?
This child has a rare and terminal genetic disorder that is about to manifest. His life expectancy is mere months. We have the power to make a difference, but how we do so is a difficult choice. The green button is for assured life now. We have developed an experimental treatment that will delay the disorder's acute symptoms until adolescence. But barring another breakthrough, he won't survive to adulthood. The blue button is for the chance of a better life later. He will be placed in our proprietary cryonic stasis program. If he survives that process, he can be preserved until a cure is found. But that may take decades, if it can be found at all.
Neither option sounds like much fun for the poor boy's family, but this is silly. Cryonics this sophisticated don't exist yet.
In the outside world, perhaps, but this is not a hypothetical, Madeline. That boy really is dying. You must choose what action we take.
You can't be serious. Oh, bloody hell.
The Assembly makes choices like this every day. Get used to it.
All right, so that's interesting. Everybody knows that humanity only lives once. You're born, then you grow, and then you die. So this choice is pretty interesting. On the left, giving me the choice of letting the kid live for a certain amount of time and then dying, and then either freezing it and then hoping a cure will come down the road. In any case, I'd rather let the kid live and just, you know, let him at least enjoy the life.
So this will keep him alive, but only for about 15 years.
In 15 years, so by then he'll be a teen, he'll discover some stuff, which is pretty interesting. Yeah.
Better a good life now than nothing but a promise in the future.
Thank you. And now, your final test.
So, where am I? What's going on?
Shit! Dad?
All the way from England. This is why I had to step out for a while earlier.
What's going on? What are you doing to him?
Us? Nothing. But you. That man destroyed your career, Madeline. He betrayed you and your mother and set your work back by years. Your husband left because of him. You had to flee the country because of him. All because he didn't trust you. He didn't believe in you.
All right, all right. I get the message.
You're a survivor, Madeline. You came to us and we can help you fulfill your destiny. But not before you make him pay for what he did. For all the pain he caused. Push the button, Madeline. Push it!
Really? And if I don't want to, can I just not do it?
Oh, God.
Is there any other buttons to push? Oh.
What are you waiting for? If you want to join us, you have to learn to move on.
Oh. This is training to become one of them. But then, learning from the guy's mistake, it's a trap, so...
No. No, I won't do this. He only did what he thought was right. You're right, Dr. Chavez. I do have to move on. But not through revenge.
I must say, I'm pleased you made the choices you did.
Spare me the bonhomie. No more bloody moral choices.
Hello, Madeline. I'm the director of the Assembly. First of all, let me assure you, despite all the theater, that wasn't really your father.
Your computer again.
He's truly remarkable. Adam, would you be so kind as to give Dr. Stone a demonstration?
It would be my pleasure, Director. After all, I know you've been watching my progress.
Or should I say Dr. Stone's progress, with great interest today?
All right. Enough. Can we just get on with this?
Of course. Make your way through to my office and we can go over your performance today.
Okay.
Congratulations, Madeline. You made it all the way. Now go on through to the next room. The director wants to speak with you.
Yeah, hold on. I want to touch stuff.
Good to meet you at last, Dr. Stone. Please take a seat. May I call you Madeline?
I suppose so. Your colleague's been doing it all day.
Thank you. I've been watching with interest, and I know Dr. Chavez has too. I think her intention was to recruit you for her own work, on a project called Pinfeather.
Director, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I've just observed Dr. Caleb Pearson trying to leave the facility with stolen data.
What? Stop him!
I administered the standard knockout gas in the elevator, and I've already called security to apprehend him.
Thank you, Adam. Now, Madeline, as to your results, let's cut to the chase, shall we? I'm delighted to offer you a permanent position here at the Assembly. We'll start your induction immediately so you can get to work.
And what happens if I refuse?
That would be unexpected, but it's your choice, of course. We can selectively wipe your memory. You'll just wake up in your new apartment, and you won't remember a thing. Of course, we'd rather make good use of that brilliant mind instead. What do you say?
Do I really want to throw my lot in with a secret cabal? What's this? Sunglasses?
Much more than that. It's a prototype augmentation headset. We call it the Memo. You'll find it contains a full breakdown of your trial results.
So, again, if he says what he says, I wouldn't want to join an organization that's, like, all up in the brains and such. It's too much.
Sorry, Director. But I think I have to decline after all. Nothing I've seen today makes me think I'd be a good fit here.
Think carefully, Dr. Stone. This is a once-in-a-lifetime offer. It will never be made again.
I've done nothing but think since I left England, and I've come to believe that science should be done out in the open. For better or worse, no more secrets.
I'm truly sorry you feel that way. Harris?
Wait! What are you...
Looks like we're making progress. Oh.
What the hell's going on? Hello?
Help! Help! Get me out of here! Someone! Please! Anyone!
Okay. So that's his ending, and it's because of the ending. It's because of the. Oh.
A surprising development in the case of Dr. Madeline Stone, the neurologist who lost her license to practice last year after conducting illegal tests that caused the death of her own mother. Yesterday, new
Earth sent me tickets in a travel itinerary.
Serious doubt on the British GMC's case against Dr. Stone, and could even exonerate her completely. We'll have more
Hello?
On that later.
Madeline, it's Dr. Chavez. Do you remember me?
No. No, I'm sorry, Dr. Chavez. Should I? Have we met?
It doesn't matter. Did you get the travel tickets I mailed you?
You sent them. Why?
Because you can help. I'm working on the H5N1 outbreak here on Calico Island, and we're on the verge of a breakthrough, but I need a neurologist to work with me, and I need one right now.
Doctor, you don't even know me. There are hundreds of...
You may not remember it, Dr. Stone, but I've seen your work, and I know you're exactly what I need. Can I rely on you to do the right thing?
Why not? I'll take the first plane in the morning.
Thank you, Dr. Stone. I have a feeling this is all gonna work out.
Oh, wow. It repeats.
Director, are you sure about this? What if Dr. Pearson was lying?
Before we wiped his memory, Carl confessed everything, and you saw the records. Helping Carl try to escape, what happened to Gunter, Adam is out of control. Much as it pains me, this is the only way.
Director, I'm disappointed. I've arranged for Dr. Pearson to be framed for the outbreak on Calico Island. As you instructed, I thought you were pleased with my performance.
How sad. Perhaps we should never have built him in the first place. Come on, let's get a drink.
The door's locked.
Director, you're being reckless. Your actions leave me no choice but to activate Project Stormguard.
What? Don't be absurd. Adam! Only I can... What the... Smythe! Pull the plug!
I already did!
Adam! No! What are you doing? Stop this! You can't!
Oh, wow. So, okay, I did something good then. So as much as the guy got framed for leaving, and the fact of the woman going back to the place after she got lost her memory, wow. And the AI literally, like, destroying the place. So in truth, the guy got out scot-free. So I think it was a good ending for the guy, even though he doesn't know what's going on. And for the girl, well, I don't know. But this is pretty interesting, and the fact that if you play this again, it'll probably be a different ending if you choose another path. So it's okay, I'm gonna say this. In VR, this is too much dialogue. And I know it's, you just explore and you kind of search, but with the pace that you're going and then searching and all that stuff, it gets a little tiring. And to me, playing it in without the VR was probably a lot better than I would imagine, because as much as, yes, VR, you get to experience the actual lab itself and trying to figure out and solve the puzzle, but solving the puzzle the way I was doing it was probably a lot better, and I probably prefer that over doing this in VR. So I'm actually happy that I went through this, because the ending was a nice twist. I loved how the ending twisted. So there's good stuff about this game, but it's the VR experience that I think did not suit well for this game. So, great job, End Dreams, for making this game, but if you guys are going to make another VR game, I think we need more interaction. That's about it. This one was too much dialogue. Anything else? Nope, that's it.
Remember, Your discretion protects the breakthroughs of tomorrow.
Alright, so if you guys enjoyed this video, definitely give it a like, share it with others, and if you guys want to see more of my content, VR, or any other games related, click the subscribe and hope to see you guys another time.